I think it's very different to the point where it's such a little set. Like, it's literally on a cul-de-sac. It's not like got loads of, like, in a big city and loads of, like, everything going on. It's just so simple but so brilliant, where you've got this little set and you've only got three main families, but so much happens, like, with them all, and they're all just entwined with each other. And I think that makes it brilliant. When you read the script and you can't put it down, I think that's when you know this is a good one.
There's something special about it. I mean, you mentioned there's these families and they are so intertwined, there's so much going on. Can you just give us the cliff notes? Can you just explain a little bit about what the film's all about and specifically where your character fits into it all?
Yeah, there are three main families, and I'm part of one of the horrible families. Basically it's about this little girl. She's obviously part of one of them. And it's part of how she's involved with all of them in some way or the other. Like, for instance, in my family, she's not involved with us in a nice way, because we don't particularly like her. Probably a bit of jealousy, but we don't like her. But then the other family she gets on really well with, and one she has a special bond with. So she's all intertwined with each other. I don't know how much I can say.
You've said just enough. Now, I mean, obviously, violence and family are two of the main themes in the film. Do you think the film has any particular messages when it comes to those things?
I think, especially with my character Saskia, everybody sort of assumes, because she's so horrible and she's so feisty, that's just that sort of scummy family, if you like. But I think that there's a lot more depth to it. For instance, the part of the story is that their mum died. So I feel like Saskia, she stepped up to be a mother. And I think that's not always to be friendly and loving. It's like how she's said. She's just very straight up and very wants to protect her family, like dominant. So I think there's a different type of stepping up to being a mum, if you know what I mean. So yeah, she's doing that.
Clearly the film has some quite provocative and challenging subject matter. Were there any particular scenes that you as a performer found difficult to kind of, you know, bring yourself into and get involved in?
I remember one scene is very, very emotional for Saskia. Very, very traumatic for her. I don't think she knew how to deal with it properly. It was very mixed. And as an actress, you've got to think, it's not how I would react, it's how she would react. And you have to think, she wasn't thinking straight at this particular moment, she'd had a bit to drink, and you've got to get all of that in it. So that was pretty challenging, but at the same time it's challenging, which is a good thing. So
does it help you having a cast of accomplished performers like Tim Roth and that round about you? Were they full of advice?
Yeah, massively. It was really, really nice to have Rory, Tim, like, all on your side and sort of not really... They were massively professional, don't get me wrong, but offset, they were very friendly towards you, that made you really at ease. So I think that helped out massively, because if they were just... If you walked into the room and Tim Roth was there and he was just really like, you'd think, I better do this right, I can't fluff, da-da-da. But he was so relaxed with you and really took an interest, and I think that really made you at ease and made it our job a lot easier.
Of course, I mean, Rufus behind the camera, an accomplished director, very well respected. How did he help you with that as a director and as a young performer?
He was exactly the same. He wasn't one of these directors where he was very just sat in one of them director chairs and just ordered everybody about. He wasn't that at all. He was very he would run lines with you. Like, if you just went up to him, anything you wanted to ask him, anything you wasn't sure of, anything about your character, anything, he would ask you, how do you see this to be done? And if he thought it was rubbish, he would say, no, I don't think that, da, da, da. And he was just very, you could see his brain just working all the time with all these different ideas. And he was just brilliant. It was amazing to work with.
I think Eloise was telling us that sometimes he likes to be a little bit playful. He likes to kind of wind people up and be a bit funny. Was there anything like that he did with you?
Quite a few things. I remember this one scene. I was doing my mascara in this mirror, and I kept fluffing my line. I kept fluffing my line, and I could just hear him laughing. It was just white, and you know, you're like, shh. But it must have been annoying for everybody. But you know, you just got to laugh sometimes. You just got to get on with it. So yeah, he was really good. He was really at ease and laid back, so it was nice.
Talking about getting on with it, what's next for you? Have you got any more acting work lined up?
Not at the moment, which is really sad, because this is what I want to do. But I'm hoping now that this has come out and it will get about a bit, and hopefully I get picked up from that. But I've done like little things, but nothing as big as this at the minute. I think everything's like focused on this at the minute. So
you're clearly very excited about the idea of being an actress. Why? And specifically, what part of the experience of making this film made you so confident that that's what you want to do with your life now?
Ever since I was little, I've never been to any drama school. I haven't done anything like that. So it's very raw for me, and this sort of thing, because I'm not from that sort of family, like that sort of, in, you know, like you're in that industry that like mummy does it, daddy does it, not that at all. Like none of my family are in the arts whatsoever. So and then especially when I come to the premiere of this, that's when it was real. I was like, I'm actually an actress. I can call myself an actress now. Like and it was just mad that when there's paparazzi and they're shouting your name and you think, me, like, look at, like, really? But it's mad. It's literally a dream come true. I know that sounds so corny, but it literally is. This is what I want to do.